In one of the earlier course episodes, we covered most of setting up and using the audio mixer in OBS Studio. But there's a new feature to it that deserves its own dedicated video, audio monitoring. This allows you to, ideally when it works, hear audio sources back in your headphones without echoing it to the stream. Again, when it works. Let's take a look right after this. I'm EposVox, here to make tech easier and more fun. Welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. If you have any questions, I have a bajillion different videos on the software linked in the playlist in the description below. It has the answers to probably all of your questions, as well as a nice little introduction video which explains how this whole course works, so check that out too. The audio monitoring feature in OBS Studio allows you to listen to the audio of a source, even if it's set only to go to the stream. This can be used sort of in place of a proper physical mixer for hearing your own microphone through your headphones, or monitoring game sound from a capture card, and so on. To set this up, first go to Settings, click Advanced, and then find the Audio section. Here, you choose your audio monitoring device. Don't leave this on default, choose your specific headphone output. I recommend leaving Disable Windows Audio Ducking enabled, unless you know what you're doing. Click Apply, and OK. Click Edit, and then Advanced Audio Properties. This can also be chosen by clicking the gear icon next to individual audio sources and then clicking it from there. This opens up the Advanced Audio Properties dialog. In the previous tutorials, I showed you how to use this to separate your audio tracks and so on. Here, you also have the ability to monitor your audio sources to your headphones. By default, all sources are set to monitor off, for obvious reasons. You have two other options available to choose from. Monitor only, mute output, and monitor and output. These are mostly self-explanatory. Monitor and output allows you to both loop an audio source to your headphones and push it to the stream. This can be useful if you have an audio track going, but for whatever reason don't want it being directly checked into the mixer and going straight to the stream. If just monitor only and mute output is echoing your microphone to your stream twice if you're trying to hear yourself, you could use this to address that by actually muting your microphone running to your stream and then having it set to loop back to you and to your stream, but that could cause a delay. I honestly can't see any other reason for using this other than, like I said, just addressing issues with the next option, which is monitor only mute output, which aims to just loop the audio source to your headphones so you too can hear it without it echoing to your stream. Typically, this is for that microphone loopback or for hearing game audio from a capture card or the like. But this doesn't always work. If it's still echoing or looping for some reason, before screwing more with OBS settings, right-click your speaker icon in your Windows system tray and go to Recording Devices. Go through each of them, click Properties, and then click the Listen tab, and make sure Listen to this device at the top is unchecked. Having this checked will already loop the sound through your computer speakers as is. You want this off. If this doesn't fix your problem with monitor only, I suggest heading to the forums. There are issues with some USB drivers or just random anomalies that could prevent it from working properly. If this is consistently a problem for you, then it might be a good idea to use monitor and output and just uncheck the audio source from going to your specific audio track with the normal audio checkboxes in the mixer box. This way, the source is consistently pushed to your stream. Although, if this causes an even bigger echo, put it back on monitor only. It can be finicky, just play around with it. It doesn't replace a full, properly set up physical audio mixer, but this is a great feature to reduce the need for one. I hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it was, hit the like button, subscribe for more awesome tech content, come follow me on Twitch if you like game streaming, and drop me a message in chat over there. Until next time, I'm EposVox, happy streaming!
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eposvox to sign up.